Hey everyone, Mark Luber here. Today on JD Careers Out There, we're looking at the alternative legal career of being a legal knowledge manager. So stick around. All right, today's guest is David Hobby, who left the practice of law to work in knowledge management. Today, he's a litigation knowledge manager at the Boston office of international law firm Goodwin Procter, and he also sits on the Knowledge Management Peer Group Steering Committee of the International Legal Technology Association, where he co-runs their blog, in addition to his own blog called Case Lines. As you may already know, at JDCOT, we help you find and succeed in fulfilling careers using a law degree by exploring career paths both in and out of law. Today, David's going to tell us all about the path of knowledge management. So let's get started. David, welcome to JDCOT.
Thanks for having me, Mark.
Thank you for being here. I'm glad you're here. So David, I'm going to ask you to tell us all about this path, who fits it best, how to break in, and how to succeed. But first, tell us this. What does a legal knowledge manager do?
Well, at a law firm, there's a tremendous amount of information that's accumulated by the course of lawyers doing their work, which is drafting briefs and appearing in front of judges and having deals and all kinds of things like that. And it's legal knowledge manager's job to organize that information and make sure that it's available to the next person doing a similar type of work, and really to try to make the attorneys work as efficiently and effectively as possible.
And so what is organizing that information? Is it just like, I mean, I save files on my computer, I just put them away? I'm sure it's more complex than that. Tell us a little bit about what you're doing to make that happen.
Sure. Well, you're working with both with people and with processes and with information. It's not just about saving a file. That is your own personal knowledge management, maybe. But at the firm level, it's a lot more it's a lot more complex than that. You might be implementing a search engine. You might be helping to set up a portal that lets attorneys and staff have information at their fingertips that they need to do their jobs. You might be setting up business processes to make sure that the information is being stored in a way that it's retrievable and reusable later on.
Give me an example here. Let's say I'm an associate, and since you interact with associates, I call you on my office phone. Hey, David, what am I saying to you?
David, my client's just been sued in Massachusetts State Court, and I need a sample motion to dismiss. And I say, well, that's interesting. Can you tell me a little bit more about that suit so I can provide a sample that's closer to or samples or resources or information about people you can talk to who have done that kind of work before? And then we have a dialogue about that, and then I would provide information about that. Or sometimes it's just, hey, I know this thing is out there somewhere. Can you just tell me how to search for it? So sometimes it's a quick consultation. Sometimes it's a little more involved. It might be setting up a system for a practice area to organize their precedents, their work product.
Interesting. So it sounds like so many aspects of a firm have to revolve around knowledge management.
Well, I don't know if they revolve around, but they certainly can benefit from the application of knowledge management.
All right, if you're on YouTube, please give us the thumbs up if this was helpful. And to see the full interview with David about knowledge management, come on over to jdcot.com, and you'll learn lots more about what it's like to be a knowledge manager, how to break into the path, who fits it best, and how to succeed. If you're already at the site, you could just scroll down to the full video. Make sure you join the membership so you get access to all the helpful video content. Thanks again for watching, everybody. I'm Mark Luber, and I'll see you soon.